Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I will tell you about two vitamins that are extremely important for our brain, liver and reproductive system. Let's start. Vitamin B4 is also called choline, coined from ancient Greek chole, bile. It was first obtained from bile in 1892. In large quantities, this substance has a toxic effect on the human body. However, in therapeutic doses, it has a large number of positive effects on the human body. What kind of effects I will discuss in this video. Choline is a hepatoprotective agent. It is involved in the restoration of the liver, damaged as a result of taking medicines, alcohol, drugs, as well as exposure to viruses and bacteria. It facilitates the work of the liver, helps to remove poisons and drugs from the body, and protects the liver from their toxic effects. Choline accelerates the breakdown of fats, thereby stabilizing fat metabolism, and also prevents the formation of gallstones. Choline has a firming effect on beta cell membranes, thereby promoting insulin production, which normalizes blood sugar levels. The substance choline has a positive effect on the human reproductive system, increasing sperm motility and reducing the risk of prostate diseases. This vitamin is found in phosphatidylcholine and acetylcholine. What are these two substances for? Phosphatidylcholine or lecithin is an important component of lipids circulating in the blood as well as the main ingredient in bile for the absorption of fats. Phosphatidylcholine helps reduce the absorption of cholesterol from food, which helps maintain normal cholesterol levels. Choline is needed to produce acetylcholine, an important neurotransmitter for memory, mood, muscle control, and other brain and nervous system functions. Choline also plays important roles in modulating gene expression, cell membrane signaling, lipid transport and metabolism, and early brain development. Additionally, choline is a good antidepressant with a strong anti-anxiety effect. It helps in cases of memory loss in old age and Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease is a progressive degenerative disease with memory loss. Therefore, if you want to improve your memory, try to introduce more choline into your diet. A large amount of choline is found in egg yolk. Also, sources of vitamin B4 are organ meat, kidneys and liver. Poultry, fish, dairy products, especially cheese and cottage cheese, as well as nuts, seeds, whole grains, oils, spinach and cabbage. The amount of choline that individuals need is influenced by the amount of methionine, betaine and folate in the diet, and also gender, pregnancy, lactation, stage of development, ability to produce choline endogenously, and genetic mutations that affect choline needs. Adequate intakes for choline in adults are 550 mg per day for men and 425 mg per day for women. For pregnancy and lactation, AIs are 450-550 mg respectively. For children, AIs for choline depends on age and ranges from 125 to 400 mg per day. The most commonly used dosage in supplements is 500 to 1000 mg choline per day. Although choline is not known to have any clinically relevant interactions with medications, you should consult your doctor before taking supplements. Long-term food deficiency of choline or methionine can lead to the choline deficiency. With a lack of choline, fat accumulates in the liver due to a violation of its transition to phospholipids. Fat infiltration of the liver occurs. Obesity of the liver leads to a violation of its basic functions and subsequently to the death of some cells, their replacement with connective tissue, and the development of liver cirrhosis. It has been established that the enrichment of the diet with choline, even with a low-protein diet, reduces the accumulation of fat in the liver. Dysfunction and cirrhosis of the liver in alcoholism are also associated with choline deficiency against the background of a low-protein diet of alcoholics. Choline deficiency can also lead to high cholesterol levels, overweight, hypertension, cardiovascular disease, atherosclerosis, diabetes, and impaired kidney function. Choline emulsifies cholesterol, so the last one doesn't accumulate on the walls of arteries or in the gallbladder. Choline also promotes the utilization of fats and cholesterol and works with inositol. Inositol? This is the next vitamin I'm gonna tell you about. Inositol, along with para-aminobenzoic and pantothenic acids, is considered the vitamin of youth. Actually, inositol is a vitamin-like substance. Like choline, it helps maintain a healthy liver, lowers blood cholesterol and triglyceride levels, normalizes blood pressure, and prevents fragility of the walls of blood vessels. Inositol can be attributed to active lipotropic factors, although its effect is weaker than that of choline. The lipotropic effect of inositol is especially active in the presence of vitamin E, and that's why these two substances can be considered synergistic. Inositol has a sedative effect on the nervous system and neurotrophic activity. Therefore, inositol might help patients with panic attacks, fear of open spaces or public places, agoraphobia, and also seem to reduce the side effects of lithium medications. Inositol has a beneficial effect on the female reproductive system, maintains hormonal balance, normalizes the menstrual cycle, promotes ovulation, and also improves ovarian function in the women with polycystic ovary syndrome. Taking inositol with folic acid reduces the risk of premature birth. Since the study including only women with a high chance of developing diabetes during pregnancy, it is unclear if inositol could be as effective in other women. Inositol may be beneficial for men as well, as it supports sperm health. Write in the comments if you have heard of this vitamin. Maybe the doctor even prescribed it for you. What was the effect? Write under this video. Inositol may lower blood sugar and glycohemoglobin levels, so that if you have diabetes and decided to take inositol, control your blood sugar and do not forget to consult your doctor. There is some evidence of its participation in the regulation of the motor function of the stomach and intestines. It has been experimentally established that inositol increases intestinal motility and its deficiency causes pleurospasm and leads to a decrease in the mobility of the stomach and intestines. Inositol deficiency can also lead to eczema and hair loss. In supplements, inositol is available in two forms, as myo-inositol and dehydroinositol. The RDAs for inositol were not established. An adult needs about 1 gram of inositol per day. Dr. Earl Mindel advises taking inositol along with choline, other B vitamins, and vitamin E. If you are taking lecithin, he advises taking chelated calcium supplements to maintain the balance of calcium and phosphorus, as both inositol and choline seem to raise phosphorus levels. If you drink a lot of coffee, you probably need inositol supplements as well. I hope this video was helpful for you. If so, hit like and subscribe to my channel. There are a lot of interesting videos ahead. Take care of your brain, liver, and reproductive system. Bye.